So I'll hand you over to Julie and we'll get going. Thanks.
Hi everyone.
Hello.
For those who don't know me, my name's Julie Weir and I'm mainly a wildlife artist. However, I do seascapes and cityscapes. I do oils, so I'm not just acrylic ink, I do pastels as well. But I picked up a paintbrush quite late on, in 2012. It was the first time I'd ever picked up a paintbrush. And the following year, I was the BBC Wildlife Artist of the Year for my hair, this one here.
Excellent.
So, and I think what was really lucky is that I found the right medium that I liked. And I think with everybody, a lot of people start off with watercolours, which are very, very scary. And they try other things. And hopefully today, by trying the acrylic inks, it might convert you. So I'm going to have a go at converting you over to acrylic inks. What I'm going to do is I'm going to break everything down. I'm going to do everything bit by bit. So we're going to have a look at the eye first, try and get the eye right. And as you can see by my pictures up here of the hairs, they can be quite different. They can be very wild and a bit mischievous looking, or quite calm. So once you've got the eye right, the fur can just go mad if you want it to. But we'll have a start. I don't know if you want to pop around, you might be able to get a better look. Lovely stuff because you don't need much at all. I'm not putting this on the table, I've just got a little poly pocket here, so you can throw it away. Glass is the best thing to put acrylic inks on because then you can just scrape them off afterwards. And then you've got a really clean palette, and you haven't got one of these stained white palettes that acrylics tend to do. Right, so that's some raw sienna.
Did you go off the grape or not?
It does. So you only put a tiny little bit out for two reasons. One, because it does dry, and once it's dry, you can't bring it back again. So you can't wet it. Once it's dry, that's it. You have to move on to another piece. But to be quite honest, you only need a tiny little amount. So this bottle has done lots and lots of different classes, and all my paintings as well. It's probably lasted about 6 months. So it's quite nice stuff. Most of my paintings are done with either a 10 zero brush, that's a triple zero. I have started going up in size. What I'm going to do, I'm doing this upside down so that you can see a bit better, but I'm using mount board here. You can use mount board, you can use watercolour paper. As smooth as you can get, really, is the best. And mount board is just the stuff you get in the framing shops. So that's just raw sienna. For all the watercolourists, I'm going to do something terrible and get some black hands. I'm just going to go around the outside of the eye. And hopefully in this weather it's going to dry reasonably quickly.
Does it blur like watercolour if it's going into wet? Is it? I don't know. I've never really used it properly.
Because you only put a tiny bit on your brush, it doesn't get that wet.
No,
really.
Okay.
I mean, you can use it quite thickly and loosely, and you could use it like watercolours as well, but I'm a little bit more tighter at doing that. Let's just see. In as well. So that was
the raw sienna, then the black around the outside. I'm just going to let that dry a little bit because I can see it's a bit wet.
Does it just sit on the mount card? It doesn't soak in?
Yeah, it kind of sits on the top when it's dried. But it doesn't take too long, and that's nearly there. Just going to put some raw sienna around the eye whilst I'm waiting for the rest.
Do you often use the coloured mount board?
Yeah. Coloured mount board is lovely to use. You don't have to put
so much background.
So if you want to cheat and be a bit lazy. I thought I'd put it on the green so it shows out more so you can see it's a little bit easier than putting it straight onto white. White takes it down a little bit. It's not far off. A good tip as well is when you put your colours out on your palette, because there's a couple of dark colours there and I can't really see what they're. Would help if you put the glasses on. If you put a little blob of white paint next to your darker colours and then mix them. So that's made a grey, so I know that's definitely a black then. So now I know not to mix the two up, so that isn't black. It does help when you're... If you're really good at putting all your colours on the palettes, then that's different. So this is transparent burnt umber. And the beauty of this, it will pick up the colour underneath. I don't know if you looked, I put my paintbrush in the water, then dry it off, then I put it into the acrylic ink so it's not too runny. Just going to work around the outside, so just inside the black, around the outside of the eye. I'm just going to go into the black a little bit. Still a little bit wet at the moment. I think today it would have really dried quite quickly. And the nice thing is you can just build up the colour, so the more layers you put on it, the richer it becomes. So I'm just going back around the outside again. And that will darken it up a bit. If you, when you're doing this, if you put your finger on the top and just smudge it a little bit, it just gives it a softer look. Let that dry. Whilst that's dry in a minute, I'm just going to put the black back in around it again. Just going to be raw sienna as the background, so all of this is going to be raw sienna. And then the transparent burnt umber again. And literally start building it up bit by bit. If you were doing it the right way round, you'd put your hand here, and what I do is just pull the brush towards me. And that gives you lots and lots of really fine, lovely lines. Let's see if we can put the white into that black here. Let's have a go. highlight in the eye. Put the white on. I'm going to put my finger on it just to smudge it. And that looks quite strong, but sometimes if you're working on white paper, it doesn't come out strong enough. So if you mix it with some just ordinary acrylic ink, it just makes your whites. So we were talking earlier on, weren't we, about the whites not being quite white enough. On here it's not too bad, but if you mix it with some acrylic ink, acrylic paint, it just makes it a little bit thicker. And you can put the eye, little dots in. They always look quite funny at first until you get all the hairs all around. But I don't know if you want to have a little go at doing the eye first. For those that want to. And you're welcome to come and use my paints. So if you want a little go at the acrylic ink, leave that there for me.
Can you hear me, teacher?
No, I was just putting some raw sienna around it, just so that, just whilst I was waiting for the eye to dry, really.
And then
could you just go over what colour went where in the eye? Yeah, absolutely.
Brown the
outside. So first of all, it was raw sienna that went down.
Yeah.
And then I did the black around the outside and the pupil. Let that dry. Then I used the transparent burnt umber and I went over the top of the raw sienna.
Yeah.
And round the eye. And then finishing off really with the white highlights. Thank you. That's all right. I don't know if you want to pop around, you've got to be up and down, pop around and have a look at the ears. Is I've used the raw sienna and just painted that ear, this one here. So all that is raw sienna. And then I've mixed some transparent burnt umber with white to make that lovely use more of the transparent burnt sienna. No, transparent burnt umber. Just going around that darker area. Now, everybody sees colours in different ways, and depending on your age group as well, you'll see colours in different things. You might see some purples, some blues, some reds in there, and do whatever you want to, really. None of it's wrong, is it? You can paint it green, that's still work. Right, so I'm just putting the dark around the outside. I'm just using the white around the outside. You're going to have a lot longer to do all this than I am. I'm just going to use some of that transparent burnt umber and white. It's a bit softer. And all it is really, all of this is dots or lines. So when you actually look at it and break it down, you can see lots and lots of tiny little lines or dots. And if when you're doing your painting, if you have a look at the way the hairs are going, so they're all going that way. And when it comes to here, these are going this way, and these hairs are coming that way. So if you can make sure when you're painting them, you paint them in that direction as well. I'm just going to darken that little bit up there. Wildlife painting as well, you use just a basic set of five colours, and that's the transparent burnt sienna, transparent burnt umber, black, white and raw sienna. That's for most of the wildlife, unless you're painting peacocks or kingfishers and then you've got some doing. Even like the cow and the sheep, they all use the same colours. Once you've got your set of five, you can paint lots and lots of different animals, wildlife.
Right. And they're quite happy to layer them one colour on top of another.
Yeah, that's the beauty of it, really. The more layers you can do, the fuller the fur will look, and it'll look like you can really get your hand down into it. So I've put the lighter colour on first, and then I've put the darker colour on the top. You could easily do it the other way around though. You could put the darker colour down first, and then the lighter colour on the top.